Hello, I'm Reza Tangisan and this is the 12th episode of the short Abaqus tutorials. In this video, I will explain how to extract the result from the ODB file depending on the time and the pass. First, let me explain the model. This is the welding model that we created in the video link on top. The animation shows the material deposition and the moving heat source on top of it. First, I stop the animation. The time shown here is the current time that you could change it by moving this bar. Now I want to explain how you could get the temperature result from the specific node during the simulation. To extract the results, first we click on this icon, select ODB field output, then continue. Here you could change type of the selection, and for nodal temperature we need to set it as unique nodal. Now we select NT11, that means nodal temperature. We move to this screen to select the node. The software provides many options such as selecting the node label, node set, and from the view. Since we want to select the node from the ODB viewport, we select the first option, edit selection, and pick the middle point of the simulation. Now we select plot to see the results. Here you could see the nodal temperature of the selected node during the simulation, as the temperature is the y direction and the time is the x direction. The plot explains that the specified node was at the room temperature, then right after the heat moves on top of it, the nodal temperature increased up to 1800 degrees centigrade. After the heat passes on top of the specified node, the nodal temperature decreases. If you want to extract the results to Excel file, you could do it from the top bar using plugin. Also, you could find the results from here. Up to here, we extracted the result from the node during the simulation, but how we could get the result from a path at a certain time? To start, please double click on the path in the progress tree, select node list, then click on right after. To select the path from the middle, we start with the initial point of the model, then we select the one after, and we keep repeating it for a few times. Up to now, you could notice this might take long time to select all the nodes of the model, but there is a trick for it. After selecting the certain number of the nodes, we jump to the end of the part and we select the last three nodes. Then we click on done and this screen will appear. By checking the nodes, you could find the node label before and after a skipping part, and also the increment, which is -7 here. Now all you need to do is replacing the node before the skipping part with the one after the skipping. After that, by clicking on the screen, the software updates the nodes and you will see all the nodes within the path are selected. Now we are set to plot the results. We click on create XY data icon again, then select path. This screen shows the available options for the extractor results. You could change the path or make it the form or on the form. We select the X value as X distance, which is along the path. We could change the frame from here, which is by default the current time of the simulation. To change the type of the results, we could change it from here, in which again by default is the current results. Now I select plot and you could see the nodal temperature along the path and a specific time. For example, at this time the nodal temperature of the beginning of the track is 200 degrees centigrade and the maximum temperature is happening around this circle shown here. So up to here you learn how to use these two features to extract the results. There are more options, but if you are interested, you could comment it below and we will make a video about it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and until the next one, bye!